Memmingren insults the Ottomans. Okay. I'm sure that won't hurt you in the future. I'd still like to bring you down. I want to bring you all down. Is DDR Jake from DDR? The DDR in DDR Jake is from DDR. Try and figure out the rest there. Ostmar. Oh, yeah, again, the missions just want me to kill the Ottomans. The same Ottomans who are going to get some more free development, because I don't think the Mamluks are going to put up much of a fight here. Keeps them off my back for a while, but that's a very short-sighted way to look at the situation. Jake, can you show the Ottoman Empire entirely and their diplomatic map? Certainly can. Let's get some admin points first and spend them on something, because I don't like having that inflation. Here are the Ottomans. This is what they are diplomatically. Consuming the Mamluks, enjoying a healthy relationship with Russia. I really want them to start touching in bad ways. Nobody is really interested in... Okay, the Danes are. Brunswick and Ravenswick. Okay. Didn't think people would be so interested in Circassian friends. At least the Russians, they may or may not be expanding here, we can't see. I mean, we could see if we check something like this. So yeah, Ottomans are scary. They also enjoy Tech 15, much like me, and much unlike most of Europe. The French have it, but the French haven't been standing up to the Ottomans. You'd think the French would ally the Commonwealth over shared interests against the Ottomans, but they are not. Is Sweden still a subject? Yeah, Sweden is oddly loyal. Very loyal, in fact. Wow. Liberty desire is 0%. That can't be right. But it is. Amazing. Jake, your voice sometimes becomes nearly muted. Any idea why? Maybe it's when I look away from the microphone like this and then start mumbling like, oh, no, no. Yeah, maybe, yeah. Because I'm bad for doing that. The chat is far away from the microphone. Maybe I should put some thought into changing the layout, but I'd rather put more thought into not dying here. Bavaria have got to go, but that's 5 years away. Ansbach are 3. And Saxony will be inside me very soon. But what I'm not doing is increasing relations. I mean, I've been trying, but people just... they want to hate me. I can't fathom it. I do wonder if there are other people, though, that would be easy enough for me to diplo-vassalize. I can take you, for example. Why are you so easy? Member of the Empire is helping. My diplomatic reputation is helping. And the threatened is. But you, on the other hand, you're like, no, 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 no. Oh well, I'll take what I can get, as long as you be nice and friendly with me. Jake is secretly enjoying the auto blob. I'm sure it's no secret. Look at that, it's beautiful. It's an actual challenge. Also, I'm going to take a quick water break, but I'm going to keep the game running. Oh, hell no, not with maxed out monarch points, I'm not. And now we can leave it running. Okay, good. Not at war. Haven't played a game with so much improving relations and trying to keep aggressive expansion down for quite some time, but AE is pretty much gone. And if I'm not expanding, then that's not good for the AE balance. However, expanding, not so easy. I mean, I will eat into Bavaria as soon as I can. And with them, Ulm is going down, and I'll probably make Ulm a co-belligerent because I don't care about the Palatinate. And once they're down, I guess I could march on to Württemberg. But they're in that Lübecker Trade League, which is a defensive pain in the bum. Ravensburg is sadly a free city, which I guess makes Trier the goal. Come on, I just wanted to purge Hungarian, but unless I get super strong, there is no stopping the Ottomans. North is also an idea. I'm not particularly scared of your alliance with... hang on, they're going to be my friends very soon. No, that's Salzburg, who sadly would not want to be my subject. Something about being an elector. When it comes to my infantry, fire and shock are about the same, but you know what they say, fire comes first. Well, that's what I say, and you should listen to that because it's important. Maybe I should get you integrated ASAP. Not integrated, but subjugated. His opinion will go down because I'll be integrating a subject here, but that's nothing to worry about. We can handle it. Just like I can handle his trade power. Jake, you should purge the Turks and the Proto-Turks, etc. We have a Serbian in our midst? No, I don't think that's particularly necessary. I'm enjoying what they're doing. They are giving us the challenge that we very much desire in all of this. Now, it is a real shame that you don't have cores for me to get, but what you do have is 12 development of Saxon land. And I want that. I also love hemorrhaging diplo points, apparently. I didn't even think about how much of those we were needing. But truly hemorrhaging. I might have too many friends and should probably consider ditching Augsburg. Damn, Commonwealth gunning down Bohemia is actually, why would you call me into this war? Are you scared or something? I mean, thanks for the warning though, I can actually pay for my forts and up that maintenance. And then maybe hide behind one of my forts, or both of my forts. Empire, okay, right. You're going to be at war with the Palatinate's friends, which includes Great Britain. But if I get involved here fast enough, then the British probably won't join in. Well, maybe won't join in. Never know. But it's not like we've been called in with a promise of land, because we haven't said we want that. I mean, sure, I'll join in. You're worth it. Puts me at war with good old Magdeburg. And they can go and slaughter my brand new subject as well. It's win-win. Well, that's not so winning. Let's just run away to Praha. And enjoy our forts being hilariously understaffed. Okay, Great Britain are getting, they're going all in. It's okay though, we have six fire, and fire comes first. You sure you knew what you were doing with this war though, Commonwealth? You didn't have to go and fight them. That's a good opportunity for Yui to eat into Livonian order, though. Well, it's important for us to sit back and really contribute to this war. It's also important for our religious zeal to fade away eventually. Didn't even have to look at the other option. It said, give me mercantilism, and I said, heavens yes. Also, I'm about to get a free army here, so I should be around to protect it. Damn, Ulm getting involved is actually a pain, because I wanted to eat them up in my next war. Now I won't be able to make them co-belligerent. Well, you don't get everything you want. I don't even think what I want to do with you, so just march into the center there. We'll keep these units to slap down on others. In fact, perhaps we should look to defeating our foes here first. Jake, occupy everything to screw the Poles over at the peace table. No, I'm not actually looking for this war to drag on forever, funnily enough. I want it to be nice and clinical. I think we're doing fine on our states management, right? Yeah, we've got tons of them. Just tons of them. And some new land to convert? No, sadly not. I don't disagree with Sweden being our friend, but they hate us. Normally I'm opposed to just leaving troops to drink attrition like this, so I should probably live up to my ideals there and pull them out. Yeah. And I'm rewarded with that great maneuver. At least Mem and Gren are pulling their weight here. But it doesn't look like a quick or easy war for Commonwealth here, so I hope they know what they're doing. Because this would be the time where the Ottomans turn around and go, did someone say war? And just smother us in units. Unkillable units. There you go, Commonwealth. I always stick to my bargains here. Could probably just use you to crush all the opposition. It's only fair, I mean, the amount of times that I've been using Commonwealth for my own end. You have to rush the autos to northern Italy before they break through the Alps, Jake. Yeah, I want to. I was planning on going through Ulm, but that has been shot down, because now I'm at war with Ulm. Wanted to hit up Bavaria, then Ulm, and then just make our way through. But now, I'll have to wait for this to be over. Hopefully I get a short truce with them. Please, robber barons, don't take everything here. Oh well, we don't like the burghers, so I'm only too happy for them to get shafted here. Which is actually one of the really nice things about telling the burghers where to stick it, because it means that we can just, in those ones where you're like, oh, I don't want to make anyone unhappy, you can go, ha ha, burghers, you get nothing. Don't even mind my territory getting all sieged up. I think this province used to be mountainous, though. I still have it locked in my head that it is a mountainous province, and it even looks like one to me. Jake, if you set land as vital interest, is there a chance the PLC will give it to you? A chance, but I actually don't want them screwing me with aggressive expansion here, even if I have none. I do need to go burning some, but for that I can go to war with Bavaria. Nuremberg and Liege are... Well, Liege is all the way over there, and Nuremberg... It's going to bother me, actually, because they're a free city, and they're my ally. And I kind of want their land, but maybe I should take it anyway. Would get rid of one of my allies. What are allies for? Eating, of course. Don't know why you'd think otherwise. Yeah, that's what we'll do. We'll try and eat up Nuremberg while we're there. It'll be our own little trial. Don't like the way those Pomeranians are going. They'll probably go and attack those guys. Hold, my friends. I know Fire Phase comes first. But damn, I like those cannons. And now they're dead. It's gonna cost me a lot of money, actually. Glad I caught that. They would have been some completely dead cannons as opposed to some almost completely dead cannons. Somebody points out a good point. Let's attach those infantry over there so they're not so distraught again. But then again, the work is already done, so just hang fire. Already done, as he says, as these sieges don't want to finish. And yeah, looking at the numbers, you sure you pulled us into a good war here, Commonwealth? I know you want to cleanse the heresy and all, but truthfully, you just want that land. Shockingly, they don't want Pomerania. Here's a joke. How about I say I want Pomerania? Jeez. When your provinces are so bad, it kills your leaders. So France have lost Paris in a war against a couple of relative minors. That doesn't speak very well for great powers who can oppose the Ottomans. Come on, lads, this siege is getting ridiculous. They give money, and we get 9 ducats of it. That won't even cover my reinforcements for my broken down cannons. Thanks, buddy. I did say it was my vital interest. Could have made them my... Oh, I probably could have said to Bohemia that I want them as a vassal. Because I'm the one with a war score on you. No, I gave that away, didn't I? Oh well. Develop a little more and you'll be a great power, Jake. It's a little more than a little more. But we are getting there. Alright, Magdeburg. Look, let's just say that I want Magdeburg. Okay, no, can't do that. But what if it went to Anhalt? What do you think of that, huh? He probably thinks, wow, bold power play. Then he takes it away from me, because he's horrible. Someday someone's going to stand up to that rotten emperor. Okay, well soon I'll get my claim on Nuremberg and it's time to strike down on Bavaria. I'm glad the Ottomans are playing ball there, this is what I need. Long live their diplomatic ruler. What happened to Austria? Was the Ottos just scary, or did Jake throw them under the bus? Not so much throw them under the bus, I wanted my own little carving of them. But the Ottomans annexed them outright. It was disgusting. Alright, Frankfurt, another one down the drain. Oh, Anhalt actually don't like me that much, so let's boost that up. I do want to get them integrated as soon as the 10 years are over. In fact, I could be integrating you if it wasn't for this ongoing war. But at least people are getting punched out left and right, and then it's all done. Naturally, they owe us the favors. And they actually did it! They converted! They didn't take the land, they just straight up converted Bohemia. That's obscure. It's insane. Still kind of want to rival Denmark. We are going to be knocking heads eventually. France, Burgundy, and Russia all don't like them, so maybe Russia and I will end up seeing eye to eye. Worth it, because yeah, you don't have allies that I care about. Alright, it's official. I hate Danes. And also Bavaria and Nuremberg have to go. That truce will be over in 1 year. Jake, did your plans to flee to the New World die with PLC's terrible betrayal over Pomerania? Well, unless you count Bornholm as the New World, and did they actually put a fort on Bornholm? That's kind of funny. Commonwealth are breaking up with Great Britain, and good thing we didn't make you a general, right? Because I want you to live a very long time. Free thinker, man. Well, I hope your next personality is just, or is it righteous? Whatever keeps that Republican tradition real high. It's like scanning my head for the right word there. It's Republican something. Ulm, Nuremberg, Liege. Damn it, I wanted Ulm. Now I've got to settle for Nuremberg. Interestingly, it's not Anhalt, but Ansbach that we want to integrate here, and siege or defense. We're all about sieging. Take them out quickly before they get a chance to retaliate. Someday we'll be a great power. Celebrate those goals by sending an insult to Denmark, because they suck. And they'll probably integrate Sweden at some point, actually, which is another horrifying thought. I didn't remember having a truce with Brandenburg. Oh yeah, I carved all that land away from them. But, let's see, Palatinate will protect them? Yeah, maybe, but I should be chewing them up first. They're not small enough for me to vassalize, sadly. But I'd love to force feed some of it to... No, I don't want to force feed it to Commonwealth, because then bad things happen. Oh, Man, Nitra didn't want to be crawling away like this. Nitra wants to stand tall, but circumstances dictate otherwise. Not worth it. Not yet, at least. I need to flesh out diplomatic first. And diplopoints keep hemorrhaging away from us. Jake, don't forget the Saxon troops, as if I could ever forget them. So we crush Nuremberg, we crush Bavaria. Wow. Russia wants to do the crushing as well. Look, we got a friend that, we both want destroyed. We have so much in common, Russia. It's kind of good, this, actually. That'll keep the Russians busy. And if the Russians are too busy, who will save the Ottomans? Oh, the Ottomans are also fighting in that war. Is it in my interest to have you help out there? I think the war would go on for too short a time if I let you through. I want the Russians to get exhausted here. Commonwealth are mobilizing for whatever reason. They're probably thinking the same thing I am. Alright, good. Bavaria can go down. Have our own little Nuremberg trial first. Crunch, crunch, crunch. It's only three nations, right? Liege, but they're like a non-entity. Accepting would destabilize the Commonwealth. What a load of old toot. It just takes Russia getting really exhausted in this war, and then I can come slamming down into the Ottomans with myself and Commonwealth. We're both at Tech 15, and the Commonwealth, they were only a little tired out from that last war. Then again, the Ottomans do have 300,000 units, the Commonwealth have half of that. I don't have other friends to really call in on such an occasion. Damn it. I want them dead. Why do I have to be the last bastion protecting Christianity from the Otto menace? Oh jeez, Nuremberg's also getting converted by a center of reformation. It's from bad to worse. It's going to stick around for a while. Oh well, not too big a concern. These guys are all going to go down, and Ingolstadt shall be mine, not yours. It's not even that big of a province. It's Nuremberg that I'm after. So I should probably take on both of them. Yeah, don't like both of these fights, actually. I can just fight one and then the other. Overwhelm both. Yeah. Woods or farmlands. That's okay. Take you out. I kind of want you to go somewhere else. Yeah, I'll take that actually. As long as you're locked in there, I'll just make the sweeping motion and everyone dies. Two siege on there. And, well, I'll be damned. I think the nobility can spare us somebody, can't you? Of course you can. I'm also going to need that extra military support, but I would like it even more if it's a level 3 diplomat. I really want one of those. I really need one of those. But I recently had decline of the nobility, and that's going to go away very soon, and then they'll be up high enough to do nasty things to my country. So maybe I don't want to do that. I'll just take my 100 mil power and skedaddle. So how good's that amazing general? He's garbage. Why would something good happen anyway? And there go all my problems. Liège does not count as a problem. It's pretty bad of me to be throwing more units onto these sieges than need be, but I don't feel like microing. We got tons of manpower. I was reflecting earlier that that's the big difference between doing live streaming and, say, doing an after-action report. After-action report, you can agonize over your game for minutes, hours, even days and weeks. But when you're doing it live, you gotta make those snap decisions like it's a Death Road to Canada. And why did I say that game? I don't want to play Death Road. So just that one province is 12 aggressive expansion. Dread to think what Nuremberg is going to be. I'm hedging lots. Well, no need for all these probably. If the others come, I'll see them from a mile away. Spain and France have gone to war. Okay, this is going to decide the West. And frankly, the good money is on Spain here. France are currently getting handed themselves by Italians and Burgundians. So it's a good thing Spain is in our good books, right? a lot of reasons they are not up for that. They're also not rivaled with the Ottomans, so actually France doing bad is bad for me. Now, it's been a long time since we've had a situation where we've gone, this is good for us. I would like that. Also, GB, why you don't like us anymore? You should like us a lot more. Okay, welcome to being part of us, Ansbach. Slow process, some might say not slow enough. They're also the wrong culture, I don't want any Francsonian. Could make them Bavarian, but why do that when we have Slovak? I'm not sure personally. So the Russians are not being slowed down whatsoever by the Swedes. And looking at it, they're about to grow a lot bigger. I should be really scared of Russia and the Ottomans. And I am. Can't get there, right? Let's just take care of all the business we have over here. Now, simply taking Ulm would be huge amounts of aggressive expansion. Because it's a non-co-belligerent. But if I do it this way, then it's still a load of aggressive expansion. That's scary. Dad, I don't want to come away with just the one province. I wanted to make a co-belligerent here. Really, one of my only chances to get Ulm whilst they are, well, to get them individually here. Could subjugate them, but oh boy, that would hurt as well. If Russia grows, Jake, the Ottomans will be their only available rival. Well, France and Commonwealth and, well, actually, the hope here is that they strip down Denmark. And then they'd have to look for someone else, and that would be the Ottomans, but it might end up being someone like Timmy. These calibers are looking awfully standardized. I've got to spend my mill on something. Not sure I even like spending it on that, but let's do it anyway. Think of it as an investment. I got these extra troops that I don't even know what to do with, so throw them onto Praha with the rest. And let's go hunt us down a Liege. Don't know what they look like, but they're probably terrible. Taking these two would still give a healthy coalition. Brandenburg, Bohemia, Frankfurt. Well, definitely healthy, but at least I'd start burning aggressive expansion. I can't see myself doing much expanding after this for a while. Just saying. Jeez, buddy. Don't look so lame. Plus, Ulm won't be part of this because we can force them out right here, right now, for all their money. And I mean all their money. So I'm waiting on that one. Jake, take Nuremberg first, then sit on Bavaria for 2 to 3 years till AE burns off. That is what one might call an impressive idea. 2 to 47. 2 to 47. Brandenburg, Bohemia, Frankfurt. And that's just from 47. I guess these are people that are already a bit wound up about all my aggressive ways. But yeah, let's be having that. Although I could take Ulm instead, and Ulm is a bigger pain. It's also opening gates for me, a lot more gates. Oh, right, well, not if you have that going on. Culturally as well, we enjoy some Franconian, which I still don't like. I don't want to accept Franconian. Well, it's a good idea nonetheless. We can just sit on our enemy for a while. Cheers, big ears. being converted to reformed, not what I needed to see. It's impressive how much unrest reduction we have even on newly conquered provinces, but that is... that's being plutocratic for you. Jake, are you going for Prussia slash Germany? Absolutely not. I would never dream of disgracing the Nitran ways by forming another nation. Plus, you don't get ideas better than Nitran's. Infantry combat ability, fort defense, production efficiency, goods produced, the single best economic one. Also get the good amount of yearly inflation reduction, tech reduction. It's just all good. Even some morale. We're only really missing discipline from the holy grail of military ideas. Here we get morale and infantry combat ability as is. Jake, put your lame army stack on Nuremberg. I don't need to. It's not even going to revolt. We'll deal with this war, and then just all will be well. Well, you make a good point. Why even antagonize? Pop goes to Liege. Wow. Pop something, alright. I shouldn't be throwing away my manpower like this, but I'm sure we're fine. Favorite government type in EU4? It's difficult because I love theocracies, I love hordes, and I love republics. And even now, with the rights of man, even monarchies are pretty good now. Okay, Liege is down and out. I'm just here for the money, buddy. Wouldn't mind some more prestige. I would quite like Nevers back on the map, not gonna lie, but I don't have the dip points to spare. So just show me the money. But first I'm gonna get home, because I got trapped last time I did this. Wow, Nuremberg has some really crappy supply. Looted, winter, and it's wooded as well. Okay, I thought it was a bit better than that. And it's good to be making the huge piles of money. Jake, what is scaring the Ottomans so much down south that they're running into Germany rather than expanding there? What? I don't see what you're saying. Makes no sense. Guess this means I should just peace out Ulm, right? If I take that, that's not even a very big coalition. In fact, next year it's not going to be anything, so that's kind of cool. Shame though, because it's Ulm that I really want, and that's just kicking the hornet's nest. Well, Ulm, guess I'm just taking the money and running. Whoa, no, I ain't here to make you a vassal. Hilarious as that would be. You don't need rivals, though. And I don't need a short truce with you. In fact, longer works out better for me. Maxed out prestige is pretty fun as well. To the point where I could actually happily spend some of that, but I don't need to. I could placate you just for a laugh. Please auto-Dow Venice or Mantua. Well, not Mantua, they're my ally, still. They may look a little broken, but they're still my friend. Maybe Salzburg need to go down. Did they become a free city? They did not. Ah, but they're in the Venetian Trade League, which comprises of laughable countries. I shouldn't even be scared of that. The tricky part is getting anything here, because it's outside of my coring range. Right, Russia and Ottomans still butt buddies. At least we're getting plenty of that papal influence. That's lovely to be smoking all the way to the bank. I should keep better relations with the Pope, mind. whatsoever. Okay. Alright, here's another thought. The Russians are allied with Nagai. If I attack Nagai... Commonwealth don't want to do that. Wait, how would that destabilize you? You got some kind of relations going on there? Maybe it's the multiple wars thing, once I round up this war. Because my thought is, I attack Russia with Commonwealth, and I force Russia to break their alliance with the Ottomans. That way we have a lot less problem. Well, maybe at least. Standardization of caliber is really nice, but I should be probably thinking about getting more development around here. Because I can actually grow high. I wish I had economic ideas right about now. Like Nitra, the capital, should surely flow into the sky. And celebrate those. Can't say no to a weapons manufactory there. Should have had one there long ago. So it'll be the turn of the year now. And that means, once this recalculates, nope, no coalition for me. And also no Bavaria for me. It took a while, but cheers and cheerio. Wish I could force religion on you too. Glorious. Oh yeah, I forgot, that's going to make people hate me even more, because I just took two unlawful imperial territory territories. Get your words right, Jake. What's so great about manufactories? They cost an arm and a leg. Well, this manufactory we just bought will make us, what was that, like 0.78 ducats a month? So let's say 10 ducats a year. So they cost me, let's say, 500 ducats. So what's that? 50 years it'll pay itself off, except they also give plus one goods produced, which goes towards the trading as well as just production. So in addition to it only taking 50 years to pay off, you can also subtract whatever you make on the trading, which will be, in my case, let's say 1/5 of its value there. Times whatever extra we make. I mean, I'm not so good with maths here, we get another 27% on top of that, but it's going to take less than that, let's say 40 years to pay it back. The better you control trade, the more money you're getting. Oh! Oh, we're just hosting an assembly here. I thought perhaps we would become an elector. Manufacturers are amazing. I don't build them often, but I don't often build a lot of buildings, full stop. Guy to be hiring. I should probably turn to the clergy and say, give me... none of these really appeal to me. Theologian will keep things quiet, but that's not what we're looking for. We're looking to purge. We do, however, want more land. There you go. At least the nobility are finally off my back. Now we have got far from trade node control. We're trading in Wien, but we barely have anything in it. Inland trading is harsh, to say the least, because so many nations get caravan power to just drink it away. Look how much Venice is stealing from us. But we do what we can. Also, the Ottomans took the center of trade that we would have really rather preferred that we had. BBQ says one day my money management will be less disastrous so I can afford manus on very hard. Oh, you just gotta loan and loan hard. Get that, well, you know what you do. You don't need me to tell you anything about this game. What I need to do is somehow teach myself how to crush Trier. Trouble is, my relationship with all Imperials is going to go down the toilet thanks to all this unlawful territory. The moment you take land that isn't your core, you get that. I think it's minus 25 might be worse, it's what broke up me in Brandenburg. And I'm still feeling the pinch of that. Russia occupying every freaking thing out of Denmark. And I'm still considering my options with regards to punching Brandenburg. But again, aggressive expansion ain't pretty. In fact, it's sitting at 50 with a lot of people. Not even sure who to rub shoulders with. If I could just penetrate my way into Italy, everything would be a lot better. That would take something like getting the likes of Ferrara as a subject. Distance between borders is getting in the way of that, but if it wasn't there, then I could be expanding in Italy, and that's what I want to do so badly. Welcome to the fine country of Bohesaxovaria. Oh, damn. I wanted to keep this guy for a long time, but it turns out he really likes whipping people. Well, it shouldn't be too much of an issue. It's just the people around here that get all antsy about it. So let's continue to hire him. He's doing a great job. Looking forward to finishing off my Diplo ideas for sure. I also really want Anhalt inside of me. I thought I was improving relations with you. France aren't losing as badly as I thought. In fact, when it comes to battles, the good money is on the Elan, even though Spain do have 15% from the get-go. Protestants should be whipped, I know, but they just keep spreading. Look, they're coming back to Ayrs! And they're going to Bohemia, even though Bohemia was force-converted. I forget when these things go away, but was it 1650? Well, that's not very good. Anhalt really don't like me. Must be all that unlawful territory. And annexing member of the HRE. Look, if he couldn't fight for himself, he wasn't worthy. Still, we're just a few years away from that. Alright, soon, very soon. Ah, that was still the thought. Attacking the guy and bringing in the Commonwealth is an option. The question is, how much do I think me and the Commonwealth could take down Russia? The alternative approach is myself and Commonwealth against the Ottomans via one of their allies, Hassa or Brunei. That tells us just how far the Ottomans have gone. That's scary. This less so. They're out of manpower. Commonwealth could try that. He's going to Nagai and just saying, come on, crushing them. The aggressive expansion is not an issue, it's only one within people over here, you know, people that matter. But that is making huge assumptions that we can take down Russia. People gobsmacked at Russia's 109 mercs. Well, let's have a look at our friend Russia here. Russia has many concerns, but I don't think income or money in the bank is one of them. Maximum manpower is pretty hefty. And they don't have any loans, because why would they? Russia have very few forts, and they are not high-level forts. I don't think anybody's really waggling level 4 forts in anyone's face. We could take Russia down. I don't know exactly how, because you can't just rip someone to shreds if they're a non-co-belligerent like that, but I could certainly feed Commonwealth, and then Commonwealth will probably turn on me because they're like that, a shower of bastards. But it's an option. It could be one of my only options to finally break the deadlock against me. Because if Russia goes down, Ottomans are going to find themselves lacking one big friend. Skiff Obs says, please, do it. 40, 80, 110, 140, 50, 60, 70, 80. Okay. Together, we're almost as many as the Russians. The Russians would have Nagai. Nagai's no big deal. The Crimea would also be there. Another not very big deal. Same with Theodoro and Circassia. But we could probably bum rush a lot of his forts. I mean, we could crack Moscow in very little time, probably. Probably. There's a lot of probablys here, aren't there? Just gotta mount all my forces onto it and hope that the Commonwealth keep my back. Jake plots to remove yet another Christian country that could stop the Otto blob, all part of the plan. Well, what I would likely do with Russia is force them to not be rivals with Commonwealth, so that they wouldn't have that in common with the Ottomans. Not sure if I'd remove France, though. That's if I get like 100% on them. And then I'd make them break up with the Ottomans. And the rest. Well, I'd have to give provinces to the Commonwealth. A great consideration, and something we'll look at later, because it's long past bedtime. I need to get myself to bed. It's been, well, slow going. I mean, Nitra has expanded by a few provinces during the past almost 4 hours. Is it still a deadlock if you get pummeled every turn, Jake? Hey, I just let my allies land go. Let's not pay attention to these cores of mine that I've lost. Or the Austrians that I just let die. Remember, it's a lovely, short, relaxing campaign to remove Hungary and Hungarian culture. We can take care of it, no problem. But it will resume on the next Grand Strategy stream. Tomorrow is thankfully a day off. From the streaming, that is. Not from work. Who knows, I might feel like going to Death Road anyway. But for me, it's time for bed, so cheers, and people saying just press the button. No, we'll press that button next time. Cheerio.